Hey Cass, we're on.
I didn't see you there. Royale, the science guy here. Welcome to my video about the sun. Now here's some things you need to know about the sun. The sun is one gigantic big star in the solar system. The light from the sun can reach Earth about 8 minutes. It is crazy, right?
Yeah, right?
The surface of the sun, the temperature is 9,941 degrees Fahrenheit. How crazy is that? It's hot. Ow! So if you're planning about going to the sun, pack a lot of sunscreen. It's very hot up there.
Yeah, right?
The sun is really big. Really big. It takes about 1,300,000 Earth planets to fit in the Earth inside of it. You see, the sun is really important for this world. We get our energy from the sun. Even plants and animals need sun, and us humans too. The sun gives us vitamin D. Well, the sun is really important for plants and animals. Well, plants, because we need to have food. Like these would taste, hot. One hot potato. Well, anyway, when you're growing plants, the sun does a project to keep them growing. You give them lots of water. When the sun's out, it grows a big plant. Plants can give energy from the sun. The sun gives food and animals energy to help us live. Plants mainly need the sun to give us some food that we can eat. Us humans and animals, anything in the world. Even ancient
plants
for cars to run in fuel.
The sun is a part of energy. The solar panels are collecting electricity from the sun. The solar oven is an oven made with reflecting panels that connect sunlight onto a small area. In your house, school, and anywhere you're at, you use electricity for lighting, watching TV, vacuuming, or whatever you're doing that has electricity.
So now you know the sun is a part of electricity, because without it, we can't use it for anything, and we can't see ourselves. Hey, who turned out the lights? Well, I better go find the sun or find a light. Whoa!
Now let me show you parts of the sun. Take a look at the inside. We have a core, the most important part of the sun. Then we have a radiative zone. That would be radiating. And we have convective zone. This area is the internal structure. Now let's look at the outside. The outside part, we have a photosphere, so feel free to take some pictures of this. And some sunspots. Sunspots are relatively cool, dark spots that occur periodically on the surface of the sun. Solar flares. Solar flares can be pretty dangerous because
it's hot!
Anyway, we have a chromosphere, and the last part is the chroma, and that is the parts of the sun.
Now let's explain more about solar flares.
Now many of you wondered, what is a solar flare? Solar flares are eruptions that happen on the surface of the sun, which occurs when stored magnetic energy is sudden released. It erupts kind of like volcanoes do a little bit. It's made like a gas material bit.
Now what is hotter than solar flares? Is fire hotter than solar flares? Well, for the fire, it's hot! Ow! But no, it's not really hot enough. How about this rocket?
You did it!
The rocket is hot, but it's not hot enough.
Not today.
Well, fireworks, well, in gunpowder, it's hot. But not really hot enough yet.
This isn't flying, this is falling with style. To infinity and beyond!
Wow, look at them go. Oh, sorry. Anyway, if you're thinking that microwaves, gas stove, flames coming out, it is hotter than the solar flares, you're wrong! Solar flares are extremely hot. The temperature is 10 to 20 million degrees Kelvin. It can be higher as 1 million, 1,000 or
100
million degrees. Whoa.
It's hot.
Ow! Well, if it's that hot, I am not. No, absolutely not. Absolute zero. Nada, no, no. I am not going to the sun. It is so hot, I tell you. Don't make me go there. Absolutely not.
Hi, everyone. I'm Ariel. When you spend a beautiful day at the beach, it's always fun to go out to the beach when it's sunny. And of course, the sun gives you vitamin D. It is good for you, but too much sun is not good for you. It could really damage your skin, and you definitely can get a sunburn. So it's important to put sunscreen. Sunscreen helps your skin. Melanin is a dark pigment found in the skin exposure to sunlight, enhances the production of melanin, leading to a suntan. All you have to do is put some sunscreen on and enjoy your day at the beach.
Hiya, folks! I'm Mickey Mouse.
Oh, hi everyone, I'm Goofy, and this is my good friend, Donald Duck.
Hello there, nice to see you.
Well, so far we heard Royale talking about the moon and the sun. Let's talk about two different things. Let's talk about the lunar eclipse and solar eclipse. Now, what's a solar eclipse?
What do you think, Mickey?
You know, Goofy, I don't know what solar eclipse means. Do you know what a solar eclipse is?
I don't think so, Mickey. Do you know, Donald? Donald doesn't know what a solar eclipse is either. Do you know what the lunar eclipse is?
I don't know, Goofy. Donald, do you know what a solar eclipse?
Oh, no!
Oh, what?
Oh, no!
Oh, what?
We don't know what solar eclipse or lunar eclipse means.
You're right, Goofy. That is a problem. We don't know the definition, and we don't know what's the difference. We need to know how's the difference.
You know, Mickey, Donald, I think we need a scientific girl who knows all about lunar eclipse and solar eclipse. Hi, how about Royale the Science Gal? She might be able to help us.
That's a great idea, Goofy. We had a call Royale to help us. That science gal knows a lot about science stuff.
Mikey, we gotta call Royale.
You're right, Goofy. On a count of three, let's call Royale the science gal. Are you ready? 1, 2, 3.
Royale!
Mick, I don't think Royale could hear us. We better call her again.
Good idea, Goofy. Let's call Royale again. After three. 1, 2, 3.
Royale!
I heard somebody calling my name. I wonder who's calling me. Oh! Those funny comedian partners, Mickey, Donald, and Goofy.
It's about time you got here.
Guys, what's going on?
We're so glad you're here, Royale. Because we got a problem. Goofy, you tell Royale.
No way, Mick.
I want you to tell Royale the problem.
Oh, no.
I'm not going to do it. Donald, guys.
What are you two arguing about? Guys? Can't get their attention.
Hold it!
Guys, I've been hearing this argument. Can one of you explain me the problem one at a time? Miki, you start.
We're trying to figure out what's the difference between a lunar eclipse and solar eclipse, but we don't know what the difference is. So we asked our favorite science guy, Royale.
Do you know the difference, Royale?
Well, yeah. Yes, of course I know about the lunar eclipse and solar eclipse. I know what the definition is, and I know what's the difference. Well, let's just head to the laboratory. We're back at the lab. Well, we're outside. But take a look at this. This is the sphere model of science. We have the sun, the moon, and the earth.
Wow, this is a big one.
The sun is very big. So, now let me tell you about the solar eclipse. That's when the moon is in between the sun and the earth. The sun is shining and the moon casts a shadow on the earth.
Oh, okay.
So the umbra is when the sun gets covered immediately. And the penumbra is the moon is blocking the sun, but you can still see a little sunlight. So when you look at the sun during the solar eclipse, you would never, ever, ever look at the sun because you could go blind. It can damage your eyes. And you may even see a night doctor. Now these are solar eclipse glasses. Because if you wear sunglasses, it is way too bright. It's not even dark enough. So these solar eclipse glasses do the trick. You see, these solar eclipse glasses are... Wrong way. These solar eclipse glasses do the trick. It's really dark. You can't really see anything. These are really cool to see the sun. These glasses are perfect to watch the solar eclipse. Try them out yourself. You know, the solar eclipses are really interesting to see. Now let's talk about the lunar eclipse. The lunar eclipse is when the Earth is in between the sun and the moon. The moon is slowly passing. You can see a little sunlight there. But the moon is red.
The moon is slowly passing from the penumbra to the umbra. Now this penumbral lunar eclipse, the moon is faintly visible. So whenever you see a lunar eclipse, you can see the moon is red.
So let me tell you the difference. The lunar eclipse happens at nighttime and the solar eclipse happens in the daytime. Interesting, huh?
That is.
Hi-ho, Kermit the Frog here. We've been hearing Royale the Science Gal talking about the sun. Now you're probably wondering, how big is the sun? Well, the warm, bright beam of light in the sky is whooping 865,370 miles in a diameter. Whoa! The sun is so big, it can fit millions of Earths inside. And the sun is the main star in the solar system. And we get energy from the sun. The sun is mainly made up of hydrogen, helium, making a steamy ball of plasma instead of solid mass. The sun's gravity is so fierce that it holds the entire solar system together, and everything revolves around it.
planets, comets, asteroids, and pieces of space dirt bikes.
On a beautiful sunny day, I like to take a walk in the park with my friend Bert. I carry my umbrella, even though I know it probably won't rain.
Well, since the sun has set, we are now going to be talking about the moon. As the Earth goes around the sun, and the Earth goes around the moon, so they rotate together counterclockwise. The moon is drifted away from the Earth. You see, the moon is always the same shape. It never changes anything, but there are phases of the moon. It takes a month for it to orbit the Earth.
So we have a full moon so far. Now it's waning. That means shrinking. There's waning gibbous. Now third quarter, it's getting smaller. Then waning crescent. Now it's back to a new moon. The moon is still there, but we can't see. Isn't that crazy? Oh, it's starting to wax. That means it's getting bigger. Waxing crescent, first quarter, now waxing gibbous. We're almost complete to a full moon, and it's fully bright again.
And after a month, the moon will start to cycle over and over and over and over and over and over. I think I might have paused or broke. Well, back to normal now. Anyway, like I said, the moon is always the same shape. It never, ever, ever, ever changes. The only thing we have to change is heading to the next scene.
Now, why does the moon shine? The moon does not make its own light. No, actually reflected sunlight. At any moment, half the moon is brightly sunlit. It's the same way that the sun illuminates Earth. The moon reflects the sun's light, making it appear bright in our sky.
So now let me ask you this. Where does the moon come from? Well, what we know of right now, our best theory that is, the Earth was hit by an asteroid, a rock from space. Anyway, the moon was formed during a collision between this planet Earth and another small planet.
About the size of the planet Mars.
The moon was formed early in the solar system's history. Between the Earth and another small planet like Mars. They smashed into each other. And the impact sent chunks and the impactor through space. And they're pulled together by gravity. And that creates the moon. So that's where the moon came from.
You know, sometimes we see the moon during the daytime. Now, why is that? We sometimes see the moon during the day for the same reason we see it at night. It is reflecting light from the sun. And its closeness to Earth, making it brighter than the daytime or the nighttime sky. After the sun, the moon is by far the brightest celestial object we can see. Hi everyone, it's me again, Ariel. Did you know the moon doesn't set up in the sky? The gravity pulls everything on Earth, including the ocean. There are tides on Earth. They easily see each other where the ocean meets land. There are usually two high tides and two low tides per day. The tides change day by day. The average is between two tides is 12 hours and 25 minutes. Whoa! So when high tides happen, the new and full moon appears in the sky. It's commonly known as a spring tide. Now how about the low tides? Low tides is when water stops falling, reaching a local minimum. Anyway, so now you know the reasons why we have tides. Because of the moon. I love tides.
Those are really interesting facts about tides, Ariel. Thanks for sharing those with me. Now, did you know what also has quakes? That's right, the moon also has quakes. Now, I want you to visualize this paper plate as the moon. Even though the moon does have quakes, they're called moon quakes. They're not nearly as strong and wild as earthquakes on Earth. But it does cause the moon to shake and wiggle a little bit. Kind of like this. Not as strong as this. That's an earthquake that has on Earth. So we know there's moonquakes because scientists left moonquake detectors on the moon to let you know the moonquake is happening. Catch! Oh well. So now you know how the pull of gravity between us and the moon affects things on the moon.
Now, who were the first people that landed on the moon? Well, it was the Apollo 11. Who are these people and what is Apollo 11? Apollo 11 was the American space flight that landed on humans on the moon. Commander Neil Armstrong and lunar module pilot Buzz Aldrin landed the Apollo Lunar Module Eagle on July 20th, 1969 at 2017 UTC. And Armstrong became the first person to step on the moon's surface 6 hours and 39 minutes later. On July 21st at 2:56 UTC, Aldrin joined him later and spent 2 hours and a quarter hours together exploring the site. Wow.
Oh yeah, the moon looks really amazing up in the sky. Oh, hi, I was just doing some moon gazing. Moon gazing means you're observing the moon in the sky. Now I want you to remember this. Remember, the Earth, the moon, and the sun. They are not really the same size, no. But they work together and they rotate counterclockwise. Now, things to remember about the sun is, it is so hot. And I'm, like I said, I am not planning on going to the sun because
it's hot.
Well, if you do, then pack a lot of sunscreen. It helps our electricity. The sun gives us energy. And wear sunscreen when you're going swimming or spend the day at the beach. Now for the moon. The moon takes a month for it to orbit the Earth. And there are tides. The moon moves as well as tides and the ocean does. There are moonquakes. Now when the moon casts a shadow on the Earth, it's called a solar eclipse. If the Earth casts a shadow on the moon, that's a lunar eclipse. Well, that's our show. Thanks for watching. Now, if you'll excuse me, I gotta do some more moon gazing. Until I see you next time, I love you to the moon. Bye! Oh, yeah. The moon is so beautiful to see. I could stay up all night watching the moon. Thing. Go outside every night and check the moon. you'll get to investigate some different cycles on the moon. See ya!